or just continue to ban it. Here in WA, a group of MPs is opposing the new adult classification, fearing such a change would lead to more violence in the community. Eliza Borello reports, and a warning, this story contains some violent images.
Get the hell away from those windows and secure the top floor! Move!
Gunfights, wars, and mass killing. Simulating violence in a virtual world is becoming an increasingly popular pastime. The question facing Australia is where to draw the line.
I think if you look at the gaming industry, they do see Australia as, you know, a little bit of a joke, a little bit behind the times.
We do need to protect children. They, you know, they don't have the capability yet to determine themselves what's right, what's wrong.
Who's juice? Who's milk?
It's an issue that's close to home for mother and state Liberal MP Liz Bajat. Mrs. Bajat and 12 of her parliamentary colleagues are fighting a proposal for a new R18 plus classification, which they claim would open the floodgates to even more violent and graphic material. Mrs. Bajat's 12-year-old son Ali is a keen gamer. Like most parents, she wants to avoid him being exposed to violence and sexual imagery, which she says there's already too much of on the market.
My son himself has come across some games and just said, I don't want to do that. He doesn't feel comfortable in one game in particular where there's a tank and you just have to drive over people and kill as many people as you can.
Currently, the most extreme material legally available in Australia carries an MA 15 plus rating. Games found to be unsuitable for minors are labelled RC, refused classification, and are banned from sale. What the censorship ministers are currently trying to decide is whether an R18 plus classification should be introduced.
We think we're protecting children by not having an R18 rating, but we're actually doing the opposite because we're letting them access it by other uncontrolled means.
Avid gamer Kerry Hutton supports the new adult rating. He says under the current system, children are accessing unsuitable material anyway because many games are being rated MA15, which should be rated R.
There's Fallout 3 where you will use heroin in the game. You have Grand Theft Auto where you can have sex with a prostitute and then kill her and take your money back. You've got Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 where you are gunning down innocent civilians in an airport.
The argument against that would then be, well, let's talk to the classification board and tell them that they need to be stricter.
But according to the gaming industry, one of the biggest issues is banned games coming into Australia illegally.
People are importing them, they're downloading them, they're pirating them. So what we're saying is if they're going to be here, let's at least get a classification label on them.
But West Australian researcher Julian Dooley says US studies have shown adults-only ratings have their drawbacks, often making games more appealing to children.
What they did was they took games where they put an R18 classification on some and not on others, the same game, and younger kids were more likely to want the R18 one.
Dr. Dooley says research has also shown a link between simulating violence in video games and aggression among gamers.
The games themselves are associated with an increase in aggressive behaviours, thoughts and feelings. They're also associated with desensitisation, which means over time the effect of exposure to that sort of content is not as strong.
In 2008, a Thai teenager was arrested for stabbing a taxi driver to death. The 18-year-old confessed to police it was a copycat murder, inspired by the game Grand Theft Auto.
It's important to sort of realise that while that's there may be something there, it's really anecdotal evidence.
And the way the industry is heading, the gap between what's real and what's make-believe is becoming increasingly narrow. Microsoft has recently developed technology which takes interactivity to a whole new level.
This is a new Microsoft Kinect console. And basically what happens here is the system scans your body and creates a digital representation or an avatar of you. And you can see the character following him across. So this is this guy's avatar. And you can see every movement that he does, the avatar does.
Australia is currently the only developed country without an adults-only category. And the billion-dollar Australian industry says that's restricting its growth for little benefit.
Financially, what we've seen is when a game is refused classification and modified, that it significantly slows down the sale of that game.
A discussion paper on the issue released by the federal government received almost 60,000 submissions. 98% of them were in support of an R18 plus classification.
Well, it was outstanding. I mean, more people signed the petition for an R18 than they did opposing work choices.
The classification code can only be amended with the agreement of Australia's censorship ministers, the Federal Home Affairs Minister and the State Attorneys General. They're due to meet again in November. In the meantime, there's likely to be plenty of lobbying from both sides.
We shouldn't be trying to protect the children by banning it altogether. We should leave that up to the responsibility of the parents.
But according to Liz Bajat, that's easier said than done.
I think that's just putting added pressure then onto parents and others who are supervising children to, you know, where is that game, who's got it, what are they doing? If it's not available, they're not going to have access to it.
Well, you're not going to beat me, Keegan, okay? That's final. My house.
I've beat you before, eh?
That was one off.
I beat you last time.
One off.
Eliza Borello with that report. Now.